This morning, I'm continuing the message series called Finding Hope in a Hopeless World. We often feel hopeless when circumstances turn against us. A relationship falls apart. The doctor gives a report, and that's not the news we were expecting. A loved one passes away. An investment loses money. A job isn't working out the way we hoped it would. We feel overwhelmed with discouragement and despair. Things aren't going as planned. Things keep getting worse, and there seems to be no end in sight. We feel hopeless. And those feelings of hopelessness leave us with some questions. What's my reason for getting up in the morning? Is there anything or anyone I can cling to without the fear of being disappointed one more time? Is there a reason for living that can help me deal with all these heartaches that keep showing up in my life? Hope gives us the motivation and the courage to keep going when circumstances are against us. We were created to have hope. We can't survive without hope. It's been said that a person can live for 40 days without food, 4 days without water, 4 minutes without air, but only 4 seconds without hope. Now, that might be a bit of an exaggeration, but you get the point. We need hope every day. We need a purpose for our life every day. We need a reason to get out of bed every day. So today I want to talk about finding hope in God's love. You can live with hope if you know and believe that God loves you. God made you to love and to be loved. That yearning to give and receive love throbs in the heart of every person. That's the way God designed us. And it's amazing the obstacles that you can overcome and the circumstances you can get through if you know and believe in your heart that God loves you every single day. Love gives us hope. And finding hope in love has been expressed in music throughout the decades. Dionne Warwick sang, "What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the very thing that there's just too little of." Elvis sang it this way, "I can't help falling in love with you." Not to be outdone, Billy Joel sang, "I love you just the way you are." And Whitney Houston sang, "I will always love you." But then there's Tina Turner's contribution. "What's love got to do with it?" And the Jay Giles Band sang it bluntly, "Love stinks." These songs illustrate the tension that we have with love. We want to be loved, but we have failed people and people have failed us when it comes to love. In fact, the pursuit of love has caused more hurt and heartache, more brokenness and hopelessness than all the diseases and wars of history. People struggle to understand love and to know how to find it. But yet at the same time, people are willing to sacrifice almost anything to find and experience love. People who feel unloved often become so desperate and needy of love that they use other people to satisfy their need. Such people will enable others. They'll even put up with abuse because they have this craving to be involved in a romantic relationship or best friendship. Psychologists have diagnosed this condition as love hunger or love addiction. God created us to love and to be loved. Yet, the problem is that love is hard to find. We all have our stories of love failures. Somebody should have loved us, but they did not. Somebody said they loved us, but that love didn't last. Somebody promised to love us, but they used us instead. Then there are our stories where we failed to love people. We tried to love that person, but selfishness got in the way. We started out loving that person, but then we lost that loving feeling. We thought we loved that person, but it was only a wish, a fantasy, lust. Real love gives hope, but we've made a mess out of love. We've perverted it, twisted it, and forgotten what love really means. So what does God say about a world that doesn't know how to love anymore? What might God do with a world that doesn't know how to love? And the answer is, God sent His Son to teach us how to love all over again. In a world where love is hard to find, Jesus wants you to know that His love will bring you hope. You can have lasting hope when you embrace the love that God has for you in Jesus Christ. Jesus' love brings you hope. If you have your Bible this morning, I invite you to open it to the Gospel of John, chapter 15. Jesus is talking with His disciples about love. And notice what Jesus says about love in John chapter 15, verses 9 through 13. Jesus says, "As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Now remain in my love. If you obey my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have obeyed my Father's commands and remain in His love. I have told you this, so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. My command is this, love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, that he lay down his life for his friends." In the 1960s, a prominent German theologian named Karl Barth visited the United States. And this distinguished, intelligent scholar of the Bible came to lecture at Yale, Princeton, and the University of Chicago. And when he spoke, just droves of people came out to hear him. And during his tour, a reporter asked Professor Barth this question: "What is the most important theological discovery that you've ever made?" And without even stopping to think about it, Karl Barth answered this way: "Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so." Jesus loves me. Jesus loves you. In Jesus, you are perfectly loved. The hope that you've been looking for can be found in three words: Jesus loves me. The hope that will get you through your darkest nights can be found in three words: Jesus loves me. The hope that doesn't disappoint can be found in three words: Jesus loves me. Will you say those three words with me this morning on the count of three? Ready? One, two, three. Jesus loves me. Let's say it again. Jesus loves me. What's so special about Jesus' love? I mean, how can Jesus' love give us hope in a world that keeps dashing all of our hopes? What does Jesus know about love that you and I keep getting wrong? Well, let's notice three things. Number one, Jesus' love is without condition. Jesus says in John chapter 15, verse 12, love each other as I have loved you. The Greek word that Jesus uses to describe his love is agape. And this word is essential to Jesus' message because it expresses an unconditional and irrevocable love. Jesus loves you. He loves you when you get it right. He loves you when you get it wrong. There's nothing you can do to make Jesus love you less. And there's nothing you can do to make Jesus love you more. Jesus' love is unconditional. There are no strings attached. And the challenge with our love is that it does often come with strings attached. I will love you if you do this for me. I love you when you do this for me. I love you because you do this for me. Our love comes with conditions. And if the conditions are not met, then the love goes away. There are moments when we get a glimpse of unconditional love in action. The mother who stays up all night caring for her sick child doesn't call it hardship, but love. The husband or wife who stays right beside their ailing spouse even as their health condition gets worse and worse, doesn't call it sacrifice. They call it an honor and a privilege. The husband or wife who gives and gives and gives so that their spouse can achieve their lifelong dream doesn't call it loss. They call it love. We experience hopelessness when we put our hope in things that are conditional. Putting your hope in the stock market can be painful because the market wavers back and forth. It goes up and it goes down, and you can lose money as a result. Putting your hope in good health can be disappointing because your health can change over time. Putting your hope in circumstances is dicey because your circumstances are changing all the time. Even putting your hope in people can be risky because people change their mind all the time. But Jesus' love for you never changes. It's without condition. It's not based upon what you do, what you have, or what you achieve. Jesus' love is absolute. It doesn't waver. It can't be changed by circumstances. It can never diminish. Jesus loves you with no strings attached. You can have hope today because Jesus loves you with an unconditional love that will never change. Number two. Jesus' love is continual. Jesus tells his disciples in John chapter 15, verse 9, as the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Now you remain in my love. Jesus loves you with a divine love that's based upon God's nature, his character. And because God is always good, you will always be loved. You have not lived, not even one, unloved day. Now, you may remember a time when you thought nobody loved you. You believed nobody loved you. But God did, and God does, and God always will love you. You may have stepped out of God's plan, but you have never stepped out of God's love. You may have run from God, but He has never run from you. You may have turned your back on God, but He has never turned His back on you. His love for you is continual. And you experience hopelessness when you put your hope in things that might not continue. Some people's love can be rather fickle. Couples come together and pledge their commitment till death do us part. But over time, their love runs out. They fall out of love. Their love runs cold. Families are to stick together like glue. But how many families are split apart because somebody's love failed? Life got hard, stress got high, and somebody bailed. Friends are friends forever. But who can find a friend when the chips are down? We were friends yesterday, but today we're strangers. You can have hope because Jesus' love is continual. He doesn't love you one day and then fall out of love with you the next day. Jesus loved you yesterday. He loves you today. He will continue to love you tomorrow. Jesus is patient with you. He doesn't give up on you. Jesus isn't sick of you. He's not done with you, and He's not overwhelmed by you. You can have hope today because Jesus loves you with a continual love that will never run out on you. Number three, Jesus' love is communicated with a cross. Jesus says in John chapter 15, verse 13, "Greater love has no one than this, that He lay down His life for His friends." Jesus' love is not an abstract theory. It's not a philosophy. It's not even just a theological concept. It's not a bunch of sentimental words that have no basis in reality. No, Jesus' love is made visible through the cross. You experience hopelessness when you put your hope in a love that's not real. It looks like love. It sounds like love, but it's empty. The good news is that nothing compares with the love that Jesus has for you. Want to see a picture of Jesus' love? Look at the cross. The perfect Son of God took all of your sin, and He died in your place. He laid down His life so that you and I can be free from sin. Jesus stretched out His arms on the cross and says, "This is how much I love you. This is how far I'm willing to go for you." Wow. It was love that made Jesus do what He did. Jesus' love is communicated through a cross. I read a story about a young man who got in a huge argument with his father, and so he moved out. The young man continued to stay in touch with his mother, and he wanted to come home one year for Christmas, but he was afraid that his father would not allow him. Well, his mother agreed to speak with his father, and if his father was willing to forgive him, then she would tie a white cloth to a tree that grew right beside the railroad tracks very close to their home. But if there was no white cloth on the tree, it would be better if the son did not come home for Christmas. Well, the son boards the train and begins to make his way toward home. As the train comes close to his home, he gets so nervous that he says to his buddy who's traveling with him, "I can't look. You look for me. Tell me, If you see a white cloth tied to a tree as we go around the corner. His friend answered, "Oh yeah, I see the tree." The son asked, "Do you see a white cloth tied to that tree?" His friend began to laugh and said, "Yes, there's a white cloth tied to every branch on that tree." In some ways, Jesus is the white cloth that our Heavenly Father tied to the cross. It's safe to come home. All is forgiven. You are loved. Jesus' love is made visible with a cross. So what does all of that mean? Jesus' cross sends a message that you are loved. The cross brings hope because it lets you know just how much you are loved. Now, imagine what it would be like to wake up every morning feeling absolutely loved. You could look into the mirror and say, "I am loved today. I don't have to earn that love. I can't lose that love. Jesus loves me just the way I am. I feel loved from the top of my head to the bottom of my feet. I am loved today, and nothing will change that reality." Imagine the hope that Jesus' love can bring into your life. Max Lucado puts it this way, and I quote, "There are many reasons God saves you. One of the sweetest reasons is because God is fond of you. He likes having you around. He thinks you're the best thing to come down the pike in recent days. If God had a refrigerator, your picture would be on it. If God had a wallet, your photo would be in it. He sends you flowers every spring and a sunrise every morning. Whenever you want to talk, he'll listen. God can live anywhere in the universe, and he chose to live in your heart." End quote. If you know with certainty that Jesus loves you, and that he desires good for you, then you can live every day with hope. Just ask Jesus to pour out his love upon you as you open your heart to receive it. You don't have to try better or become more worthy to receive it. You can just come as you are. Jesus' never-ending love will give you hope as you have to face the changing circumstances of life. With Jesus' love filling your heart, you can have hope as you travel through life day by day. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for your incredible love. And Father, we do live in a world where love is a mess. But Father, thank you that there's a God in heaven who truly knows how to love. There may be people in our life who don't know how to love. There may be people in our life who struggle to even know what love is. But we can wake up every morning knowing that our Heavenly Father loves us. And that he's never going to leave us, never forsake us. His love is without condition. And we can spend every day feeling absolutely loved. Father, we need hope in a world where circumstances do turn against us. We need hope in a world where life is tough sometimes. And Father, your love gives us hope. You love us. You're with us. We can overcome obstacles, we can get through circumstances because of your great love. So, Father, it's my prayer today that everyone here would just get a glimpse of your love, that they would feel your love down deep in their soul, that they would leave here today knowing that God loves me and that makes a difference. Father, thank you for your incredible love. I pray in Jesus' name.